Yeah, this has really been a focal point for a lot of people. They come here and have their cup of coffee and chit-chat. They get together, and it's really like a old general store where people came and sat around the hot coal stove and chatted about what was happening, if anything was happening. But here in Coney Island, something's always happening. And you just want it to all be positive. Positive because Coney Island only deserves the best. It's the greatest story ever told. It really is. You stop to think of it, you know. Put a little plow in.
Love to be dressed better for this performance. Mr. Major is my Prince Charming. He has the best meat in the world, best bread, very fresh, and we love Coney Island. And when I kissed the little frog, he turned into Mr. Prince. That's my Prince Charming, and he has the best food ever right here on Mermaid Avenue in Coney Island. Yay! God bless. Amen.
When I smothered them down in the onions and gravy.
Your pork chops are in the movie.
This is what makes our hamburgers so good.
nice fresh meat anywhere. What is it there?
This is the secret murder burger. Huh?
That's the murder burger. If I just sold murder burgers, I bet I could do a nice business. I had it set up outside, just selling these.
Going up in form.
Will I get it finished? And we'll put it on the fire. Little fried onion on there.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. Burger, yeah. It's unbelievable. Your burgers are unbelievable. Right? And you're going to become a hair when you get older now.
Oh, sure she will. She'll bring her children in here, too.
To anyone who grew up in Coney Island, Jimmy Prince was the last link to the past. Jimmy once told me that his job was like being on a speeding train, and if you spent any time with him, you could see it was true. His 60-year journey was all about love and respect. He gave respect and got love in return. No one else was quite like him. He was truly the heart of Coney Island.
The Cabilla, that's the Cabilla Kanish, they're the better ones.
Very good.
Yeah. Been in business for years. They got a little red truck that goes around. That 1822, 1, 8, 9, 9, 9, 18, 18, 17 altogether. Oh boy, you got a promotion, huh?
Quite a few.
All I need now is
a tap.
I'll get you one. I got a load of them. Yeah, that's the good stuff, the pine. That's all you'll bring me. Just the pine sort of. It's got that nice smell. And he stopped for a minute, took his kid in as far as the doorway here goes, and he said, see that? That's something you won't see anymore. Sawdust. The kid was bewildered, you know.
Oh, he's family. He's like a second dad. He's like the neighborhood's father. Believe me, he knows what you need when you need it right off the bat. Right when you need it, he knows what you need.
I knew him when he was small.
I told him. Feeding me since I was a baby. And now look at the outcome. Beautiful.
Out of control.
I don't know where it came from. I'll say it was on you. How's that?
My son was a lifeguard there for 8 years.
Oh, he was? Oh, now we're talking.
With eyes like an angel's eyes, wherever I go, in the roaring traffic's boom, in the silence of the lonely room, I think of you.
Everything's changed so much in school.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know what it is, too? The kids that go to the school don't go as students. They go there just to, as compassion, you know, or any
You're
of that stuff.
Taken out of context.
No.
The old 40 movies are good. I like to watch them. I don't like the new movies.
But I'll never forget Casablanca. That was That was one of my favorites. Going to the Brooklyn Fox with my wife to see the Eddie Duchin story. And it was in the summer, and I was wearing short sleeves. And I'm watching the movies, and I felt water on my arm.
Oh, wow.
I was crying.
Hell is name. Hell is shop. Two little shops that were on the side of the apartment building there on 20th Street.
And all the illustrious people used to live in that apartment house between 29th and 28th and 29th. All the wonderful people that lived in that building there. Yeah. I tell you, it's amazing, all of them.
Oh, okay, no problem. I'll make sure he gets it. Okay, sweetie. Take care. Love you. Bye. Bye, bye. Bye.
Yeah. These are items that one of my customers, Ms. Bernstein, who have had for about 50, 60 years, lives in Seagate, sort of a shut-in. And she has little favorites like the Yankee Doodles and little Chinese fried rice. So we go out, we get those few items for her, and we put it with the rest of her meat items in, and we deliver it. But it's such a joy for her, for me to be able to do it for her, and the joy that I get mostly is when she thanks me. You know, she.
Hi, Mike.
Hi, how are you?
Good morning.
Hey, good morning.
Thanks. Thank you.
Thanks very much. Bye now.
What are you doing?
Next stop, Hollywood.
Oh, it's too late.
Go.
I came here to New York, all my girl want to see was Coney Island from uh-huh. Canarias, you know, from the movie, from whatever. I said, we have to go to Coney Island.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
We went to Coney Island the first week.
And
so I say, wow.
Yeah, it leaves you with a nice impression too, you know.
I am not with that girl, but I am with Coney Island.
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
Coney Island is still with me.
When I first came here to work, I didn't know anything about Coney Island. I knew there was rides and things. I didn't know anything about it. I was going with a girl at the time. And when I worked here for 1 week, at the end of that week, I went back and I told the girl, I found another love. So we ended our relationship, and I took up with the Coney Island. It's been a wonderful. Got it? Got it? M1? Everybody loves our chicken salad. You know, it's low in... there's no salt added. You know, it's salt-free, so... You know what to highlight, what to look at, what to bring out, whatever. And, you know, you gotta know what you're doing there. Involved in it, and the true meaning of what the store was set up at the beginning with quality meats and good service, and you want to be a part of that. And today, of course, there's so little of it, no matter where you came. You know, you have to be in my shoes to realize what it's meant and what it was, and what it hopefully it'll be.
The best chicken salad I ever ate in my whole life. No store, no deli, no pork store. Nothing comes near this chicken salad. It's all natural, no junk in it.
For that, you're going to get
It's made with love from Mr. Jimmy Major.
Better in this mirror.
Do you know that this goes back, as long as this store has been here and that mirror has been there, women always looked at that mirror and said they would look thinner in that mirror. And that's a God's honest truth. They all like that mirror. I wouldn't have any trouble selling it. Want to buy one? You know, you have people come in the store. in stores all over. But there's something special about the ones that come here. I mean, I get such a variety of people, and the characters, there's no end to it. And it's such a fun place to work. It's not all work, it's a lot of fun involved in it. And I guess that's what keeps you going. That's what makes Coney Island so different than any other place.
Why didn't you run for mayor, huh, Mr. Major? You should have been for mayor, right?
Yeah,
I would have voted on you, you know?
I'm worried about the chicken voting for me.
That's the rooster of Coney Island. Easy. Bye.
Thank you very much.
We love Coney Island. Bye.
Late one night in the winter of 2007, Jimmy confided to me that he was considering retirement. It was a painful decision, and he didn't really know how to end it. He knew that closing the store would be devastating to the community, and for the first time in his life, he became depressed. He asked me to keep it a secret, but his friends and customers sensed it.
Well, I really think the end of November, mm-hmm. I think I'll pack it in. I won't be here. I don't think I'll be here for the Christmas holidays. I'll end it with a Thanksgiving holiday and be thankful that that I lasted as long as I did. It's been a wonderful run. I've come to the point now where it's starting to affect, you know, my family life, and I feel that this is the time now. I have to do what I have to do. You know, I can't let the love of my store and the love of being here in Coney Island for so many years, it's such a wonderful love affair, but I have another love affair that I have to take care of, I can't neglect. And when I look at both of them, of course, the other love affair is the one that I really have to take care of. Yesterday I realized, you know, how much it means being with my grandchildren. You know, it's just like such mixed emotions, and I have to just, you know, separate them. And in separating them, I have to go in the direction that is meant for me, which is, of course, my family.
To treat that with respect.
Oh, yes.
The chairman of the board. Mm-hmm. And the machine was running, and I just put it right in. It happened so fast. It was amazing how it did, because I went down like that on an angle, and I didn't even feel it was like a warm sensation.
Yeah.
And she did the surgery. It took her 3.5 hours to put it back together. She said that I had cut the nerve, the bone, tendon, and something else. There were four things, but she did a pretty good job. It's
great.
It kept me overnight, and then the next day I was right back at work. And you don't take time off for too many things, you know. And when you do take time off, you make sure it's a short time.
He looked at me, and we're walking about 15 seconds, and I said, "Stop, look at the building." He looks at the building. It's the world headquarters of Thaw Equities.
Oh, my God.
So Andy gives him the Italian, you know, gives him the...
He wasn't a brick hand.
He gives the building the horns. He said, I'm going to wait here for Joe Sitt. I said, you're going to wait a long time. Let's go to lunch.
Companies, how heartless they are, have no feeling, no compassion. And it reminds me so much of Joe Sitt. He has absolutely no regard for the people.
Well, developers, as a rule, they're a selfish bunch. They're out to make a buck. And that takes away the privileges of the masses, the have-nots of society. They're being deprived of the pleasure of coming to Coney Island every year and the beauty of getting away from the humdrums of life and get a little excitement in their life, even for just one day. And it's cheap, you know? And they're depriving the public of this vast, enormous amount of joy and happiness.
It's a place to come to enjoy. When you get men coming along, self-interest, lying to the public, meeting in back rooms, making deals amongst themselves, not interested in what the public wants and what the public uses and enjoys, but what satisfies them, that few select group who with self-interest groups, and they take away the joy and pleasures of what Coney Island brings. This cannot be tolerated. It must be stopped.
Well, Jimmy is a person who is devoted to the store, and he's not doing it to make money. He's doing it because he enjoys it. And he's a historic part of Coney Island. It shows the dedication that a person has, and he even makes home deliveries, even at his age now, which could be dangerous, but you know, he doesn't care. He's thinking about his customers. When I come here at night, I look in this window and it's lit up. To me, it's like a shrine, a sort of shrine of integrity. That's what I would classify it as. It's like being in the Hall of Fame. So I would very much, I would be honored to be placed in this place.
You know what we need? We need a good bar. Open up a nice bar. Don't you think so? Coney Island has always had bars.
They had bars every block.
Now they have none.
You're lucky you find it.
Right?
The only bar you got is...
You can't find them. You had what's the name on 23rd Street?
You had Dolls, you had McCabe's. You had Whitey Lowe's, you had Scobel's.
What was the one on 23rd, on the corner of 23rd?
Clarkie's.
Clarkie's. They were nice people.
Rose?
Yeah, Rose. She kept it going for a while. But
yeah, until she got sick.
They were good people.
Oh, yeah, hey.
Maybe in your retirement, you could open up a...
I'm already retired.
Speakeasy. Yeah. We call it the speakeasy.
You know, I worked right here for Jimmy 11 years. And, you know, I don't, they went the years too fast, and I feel like I just started now, you know.
And he knew my mother for like 47 years. He's been here a good 60, and he's a real decent guy, man. And I hope him many, many more years. He's got what is known as a turkey burger, fully loaded. I named it that. Come and get some, please. Come and get some.
Well, what would you say, 40 years at least? Yes, well, it's 40 years since 62.
You've been coming here since 62?
That's right.
Is this the best?
The best. You can't beat it. You can't beat it. Hey.
This is right here, CI Coney Island heritage right here. I love this store.
To this day, I now pick up meat here and bring to my daughter in Montclair.
Since I was 5 and I'm 35. Always been here. He's still here. My mother's gone, but he's still here. Great guy.
People coming around when it's time to be elected. And right. And you never see them anymore until it's time again they want you to vote for them. That's not right.
I'm back again.
That's not right at all.
No.
He's very considerate. He's very good to people. That's one thing. I know that much for a fact. He's got a good heart, I'll tell you that. There won't be another one like him if he retires. Because all his kids are lawyers, doctors, or whatever. And he struggled too. Give him credit there. He's always helping other people. Anytime somebody come in here hungry or something, he always gives them something. That's one thing I could say about him. He's very good. He won't turn them away. But sometimes they get annoying, you know?
The push there.
Yeah. I've been coming out long, Jimmy, about?
Oh.
Maybe about 40 years?
Yeah,
since I know him, about 40 years.
40 years, sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's when I had all black hair.
Yeah. Well, young, black hair, blue eyes. And everything.
Well,
that's what I said. If Jimmy ever closed down, he's going to be really missed a lot.
Ben, you look great.
How
you
doing?
That's my
yeah, we both got older, huh, Jimmy?
Who?
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 Not me.
Is there an owl in here?
How's it?
Didn't you have a birthday?
Did I have one? Yes.
I know, me
I'm
too.
I'm going to have a lot more, too.
Hopefully.
Right?
What do you think about this plan?
The plan for what?
The plan to put condos in shopping malls.
No, no, that's not what this Coney Island is for.
What's it for?
What is it for? It's to bring your families and your children like we did 50 years ago when my kids were young. You come, you go on the ride, you go to Nathan's, you spend a nice day. That's it. Kind of. Who's going to come to a hotel or well, when they originally said hotels, who wants to come to a hotel in the middle of the winter and freeze their ass off? Nobody's interested in Coney Island in the winter. Leave it alone.
Hey, hey.
No. It's so sad.
How long have you been coming to Jimmy's?
You really want to know?
Yeah.
Then you'll know how old I am.
Sorry.
46 years since I moved to Coney Island. And that's how long I'm coming to Jimmy, when he was just a little pipsqueak. No, we're the same age. Jimmy, come on, I gotta get out of here. Places to go. Pound and a half, you know, the usual beef and pork.
Pork and beef?
Yes, yeah. That's all.
I told him, I told him we got, good morning.
Hi.
I told him we have a lot of good barbecues going on to try to provide us a little sun this afternoon. So we'll see what happens.
Okay,
all
thank
right?
you very much,
you
Major.
Take care of
yourself.
You
have a nice day.
I came to wish you a happy Father's Day. I said, let me stop and see if you're here. Happy Father's Day,
thank
sweetie.
You so much.
I'm on my way to bury my father.
All right.
He died Thursday.
Take care of yourself. When?
He passed Thursday.
Oh,
yeah.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, but well, he was 86. He lived a full life, and he worked right up to the day he died.
God bless him.
Yes,
he had
did.
The right sin, and he had a wonderful daughter.
Thank you. Thank you. I love you.
Stay
God
well.
Bless you,
Take
too.
Care now.
All right.
Bye.
I'm
over here in front of Mr. Major's sandwich shop, and this is one of the best places that's been here forever. You know, it is an icon. It's just like the Coney Island ride.
I know that.
And
but
if you want to come here to eat something straight and positive, show up, because Mr. Major makes the best sandwiches in the whole world.
The bones are for Duke and Major. That's Jim McCullough's watchdogs. They're beautiful dogs, and they've been here to the store on a number of occasions, and when they come in, they know just where their bones are coming from. Supper is ready. I'm sure if they had a phone, they'd call me. Just a dangly.
There you go.
Now you sometimes you feel like you're doing missionary work. You know, in the latter years anyway.
Remember the night and the chair and the seawall.
When I was little, I liked the kitty boats. And I also love the bumper cars. We did lose some.
Now this lady outside, she lives in Seagate, Marie. She's such a wonderful person, and well, you know what she does for a living? She makes wigs for the Orthodox Jewish people. Her and her sister, and they're up all hours of the night doing it, you know, because they take care of their house.
Jimmy, they're here.
Okay, here we come. How are you, fella? How are you? All ready? Yes, here we come.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. Over the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Thank you. Hi. We're going to mix up.
Thank you.
All right.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas.
And a Happy New Year.
Oh, listen.
I'm going to give this to the young lady who comes here. She's a, you know, black lady who's been a customer of mine for many years, and she's just a wonderful person. Displays a lot of confidence in us, and she'll pay in advance and then pick it up later. You know, that type of a customer. And she's always has a good word, always has a good laugh. And one day she had a serious heart attack here in the store. We got the ambulance for her, and she never forgot that, and has, you know, come back, and she always reminds us and laughs about her closeness to being dead. And you know, today she's still alive.
A cop shot. I thought it was a man. They said he shot. The Channel News said that it was a boy at Gospel Assembly.
A boy that got.
Yeah, killed. He died at Coney Island Hospital. It was about 2 o'clock. It was doing all the cops. They was going crazy. Down.
This is the Coney Island Gospel.
You saw all the cops, yeah. Right on that film.
Yeah.
What had happened in the church?
Oh, did it happen in the church?
I think it happened in the parking lot.
Oh.
Yeah. Cause Sister Connie be down there all the time.
Oh boy, that's terrible.
Yeah. Yeah, they was going crazy. I
didn't
know what happened.
Somebody got shot at O'Dwyer, too, the other day.
It was Sunday. It happened Sunday.
Yeah, that was the building where I used to live over there.
Yeah.
What was that about, you know?
An argument, and the boy shot him, and he died. They did his funeral Tuesday.
Is that the one on
33rd? Yeah, yeah.
Do you know that a man came in and had a schematic? Our schematic didn't match up. My father would have ran down and bought that land. It sold for $12,000. And Home Depot came in and bought the land for $5.6 million. You think I would look like I do now if I would have had that land? And that's a fact, Charlie.
I have, you know, so much compassion for the people and the love for the people. And you go out of your way to do all you can for them, knowing that this is what they want. It comes a time when you retire and close up, they'll turn around and say, where are we going to go? Where are we going to get our different items of baby chair? Where are we going to get this? Where are we going to get that? It's not out there for them to get. It's because the stores don't handle that. The stores don't see what the customers want. And they don't handle them in the right way. They don't have that feeling to...
Let me tell you something. I love your fucking cold cuts, your hog head cheese. Excuse me, person. Yeah. You make the roast beef. You know, you make the chicken. I get it all the time, Major. My cousin used to go, yeah, we're going to Major's. Oh, Major's? Yeah, we're going to Major's. We're driving the car, go over. And we always come here. And a lot of times this place is packed, Major. Yeah. And you know what I'm talking
about. All right, I'll give it some consideration.
Major, don't tell me that. Just tell me that, Major.
No, I'm going to give it consideration.
Nah, but all you gotta do is give it a shot, Major. If you don't have to be here every day, Major, no, you right. Did your time. You did your time. Let the business work for itself.
When, you know,
you can do that, Major. You get the good cold cuts. You get the good meats and stuff, Major.
I gotta keep my customers in shape, you know.
Yeah,
that.
Major. Mm-hmm. Don't
they
give
mean
up.
Too much to me.
Major, right? Promise me that,
okay.
That you'll stay.
I'll give it considerable.
Promise me that you'll stay, Major.
Okay? I'll do my best.
Because my aunt was over here yesterday.
Yeah.
Since she already got stuff from me over there. Yeah. So she was like, oh, I heard. And I said, yeah, you see who's on the news here. Major's leaving. Oh, no. What? What are you talking about? I said, yeah. I go to Major every week.
All right. Called the Major. Yeah. We always swore to God that was his name. Yeah. It wasn't until we got older. We were like, who's Jimmy? Remember my mother said, his name is Jimmy Prince. His name is not Major. God rest her soul.
By last day, I'll wrap things up. And I'll have to put a lot of things in boxes, start packing things and organizing things. And whether that'll ever be done, I don't know. But this will be it. I've done all that I can with the orders that I had to fill. And the people that want the items that you can't get when I do close. So I've kind of filled them, but you know, as I stay here doing these things, I become more saddened for the fact that I have to close it up. I feel really that I could go on forever here, but I do have a family which I don't really see, although this is a family here too, so you're really torn in two different directions. The people I realize need you, they need the care that you've given them over the years, the products that they can't get anywhere else you have, and when you shut that off, it's sort of like you feel so guilty, and you're really sad, and I would close now, and I would like to continue to participate in the community in any way I can, even if it's just to stroll on the boardwalk and meet my old friends that go to the Mass here on Sunday and see the old-timers that come here and buy their bread and chit-chat. And I know that just seeing them gives them an uplift, you know, because I do try to uplift all these people as much as I possibly can, not only with the product that I sell, but with the chit-chat that you give them. And, you know, all this coming to a close is, it's just... I don't know. It's sad. It's sad. It's happy. It's mixed emotions. But I guess I have to do what I have to do, and I don't do it with the right feeling. But we'll do it and keep smiling. That's the main thing. I let a smile be my umbrella.
One of the stores I used to come to when I was a kid to come and get my food from. And I'm really going to miss this place. I'm going to miss him. Thank you.
Gotta say bye to him.
Three, two, one. Jimmy says he doesn't know what's going to happen to the store after he closes down, but predicts it'll most likely be demolished to make way for new development. Okay.
to the 44. Oh, okay. I got two for the price of one.
Oh my God, Jimmy, I'm gonna miss you so much. But I know it's the best thing.
I'm gonna miss you a lot. I wish you the best.
Having you accustomed to this, just take care of yourself. You hear? Stay as nice as you want.
You too, likewise. Okay. God bless you. Thank you for everything. Thank you.
Make me proud.
He never
was. Yeah, I know.
All right, just take care.
I love you so much. Okay, take care of yourself. Nice meeting you, sweetie.
Where are you belong? Bye bye.
I'm not sure yet, but you know, I'm going to stay in Coney Island. Honey, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Two hours.
How are you? Thank you so much.
My last name.
I appreciate it.
Yeah.
Sit
at
the bench outside?
Yes, I'll do it. Oh, that's the one thing I want to do. I want to have it stationed in the ground.
We can take a pic.
Don't let my wife see
it. Oh!
The button.
This one, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, look at my bubbles. I gotta hold it?
Is it on?
It's gonna save me to dim.
I just not think for security. I got my
plate. Sure, of course. Sorry, I'm making a mess here. I should have a fork in my hand.
Oh, that's
no, this one's going on Sports Illustrated.
All right, Jimmy.
Hi, hon.
Thank you. God bless you.
Yes, yes, sign. Yes.
You got to have any cake?
Have fun.
You guys need to.
Have fun.
I will. If it's anybody, if there's any more fun than I'm having here.
I've been coming here to Jimmy's for over 50 years. It's going to be a sad day now that, you know, Majors is not here anymore.
Hey, Jimmy, I know you're busy, but
yo, congratulations. About time he gets out. It's good. Brings back a lot of memories.
Eric's graduation for Adam's graduation, my mom would call up and say, you know, you be ready at 2 p.m. I'm coming down to the store to get you, to take you to the graduation. And she would come down, you know, 5 minutes before him, it would call at, let's say, 1 p.m. and say, I'm going to be leaving soon, be ready. Call at 1:30 p.m. and say, you know, I'm getting in the car now, I'm coming down, make sure you're ready. And we would get here, you know, 5 minutes or two, and he would still be cutting up meat, not dressed for the occasion. And my mom would have to come in and convince him to get ready and put on his, you know, put on his good shoes, put on a new tie, take off the apron, get in the car, because we gotta get to this graduation on time. And you know, it's more than a store to him. It's a, I don't know, what would you say? It's a life. It's a
calling.
A call. Yeah, it's both. It's more than. It's not work. I guess part of it. It must be fun for him. Because there's no way that someone can work 7 days a week for 30 years.
Growing up, I was I didn't see him very much, but I was always proud of him. And I think one of the biggest days I remember when I was a child is coming into the store and seeing a sign that he put up that said, you know, now closed on Sundays. And I can't remember being so ecstatic. And I think that maybe lasted a week. And then it went back to normal. But, you know, do I have any regrets? Do I get upset that he wasn't around more? You know, I never really regret because you can't change things. And I'm proud of him. And, you know, he's happy. And he was always there, you know, if I needed him, he was a call away. And, you know, to know that he would put down the phone, you know, put down things and have the time for me, even if it was for 2 minutes, that was enough. You know, and You know, what else do you do when you have seven kids that you have to raise? You know, you have to work. And, you know, I appreciate everything he did. You know, growing up, we always got to do the sports we wanted. When it came time for college, it wasn't do you want to go to college or can we send you to college? It was always, you know, which college do you want to go to? And that's more than a lot of kids. That's an opportunity that a lot of kids don't get. And, you know, both my parents made a lot of sacrifices and, you know, to give us the things that we wanted. And for that, you know, I'm eternally grateful for them for that. You know.
All right, that's burger 812 today. We ought to have a tote board here, you know? Like a Jerry Lewis telethon. You know? All right, let's go to the tote board. We're up to 812 hamburgers.
812. Good.
Just like Burger King, right?
Was that the Frank on there that all that time, huh?
Yeah, he was giving me quotes. I was like, what else are you looking for?
What, Frank?
Yeah.
Frank, he's
wondering if Jimmy opened up today. We had a nor'easter. Well, what year was that, Jimmy? 94? 92. And who's here? Jimmy. With pans of hot water when he was stepping to warm his feet up. And you're wondering if he's coming in today? Please. I had no doubt.
Jimmy, yesterday was your official retirement. Today is the biggest snowstorm in 5 years. And how's retirement going for you?
Oh, it's great. I started off shoveling the snow out front, and now I'm into filling the orders that I couldn't fill over the last couple of days. And then maybe I'll look for a really official retirement. I have my doubts, so. Here we go, off on the orders.
He put Jason, the trolley cars, and then now they're taking Jim, the last of the Mohegan from us. He's gone. He's gone, man. It's a loss. It's a big loss to the community. Now we got nothing. Now, the only butcher left here. You know, the only, honest, besides getting me, get good conversation from the music is great. The company's great. Conversations are great with Jim. Yeah, he's like a family. He's part of the family. He's been here, God knows. He knows I'm 53. He knows me since I'm 5 years old. And, you know, that's the loss, though. You know, it's not the same every day you wake down. You're looking forward to coming to the store to see Jimmy, to talk to him and sit down and drink coffee with him and watch. You know, it becomes part of you. Then it's like having an arm, a right arm and left arm. They take it away. You know, you feel lonely now, missing my left arm. You mean, it's not the same. It will never be the same. No matter if they put somebody else here, it could never be the same. It will never get better. I just hope it does get better now for the future, for these other kids with this super Astroland and everything. I think they just want to put condos in there and everything and forget about the avenue, Mermaid Avenue. This is part of Coney Island. Mermaid, Neptune, and Surf is Coney Island. Not just Surf Avenue and Astroland. We built the neighborhood inside the neighborhood right here, not the outskirts, in the inside. You know, they need to come in and talk to the people personally, you know, just don't have meetings without the people being involved.
You know, that I had taken the previous week and I couldn't finish them. You know, with the excitement and also I couldn't finish them, and that's what I devoted this week to, getting them all done and, you know, freezer wrapped, and they came and they picked everything up. And I'm here waiting for somebody to pick up an order that they couldn't pick up yesterday. So,
you've been operating here at a huge profit, haven't you?
I'll tell you, I don't know why I stayed in the business, you know. I loved it and I loved the people, and I kept the business going, although I wasn't making any money. In fact, I was losing money. And I kept the business going. I often say to myself, why did I do that? I put myself in a hole. And it's a pretty tough hole to dig yourself out of. And why do you keep doing it? You do it, you get up every day, you go to work, and you do it because you love the work and you love the people, and you just do it, you know. But it's hard to explain to people, you know. People say, yeah, you're not making the money, you're losing money, why do you stay in business? But, you know, the people, they appreciate what you've done over the years. They appreciated everything that you put into it, and I guess that's the reason. I don't know, staying business, losing money is the smart thing to do. There's so many out there now only making money, and you see what that has caused them too. So I don't know what you... I think having the love of the people and the appreciation of the people is a lot better than what the CEOs who are getting these big bonuses have to go through. So I'll stay with my hand. Something that I'm prepared for one of my old-time customers. It's a veal roast that's stuffed with the ham and cheese, and it's garnished on the outside with strips of bacon and seasoning. And along with that, we put the cooking thyme in there, and she's all ready to go. Preheat the oven at 325 and cook it for 2.5 hours.
Is this your last special order?
Veal delight. Yes, this is. This is the last hurrah, as they say. That reminds me of what's his name, the fire eater over at Freddie Sandell's. Aji Baba, yeah. His real name was Lou Schwartz. He used to come in here so disheveled.
Aji.
He'd come in and he'd get stuff, you know, and poor. You know who I used to feel sorry for was Milo the Donkey Face Boy.
Oh, yeah.
He was so simple, you know.
Yeah.
And he died all alone in his room in Coney Island Avenue. Yeah.
Milo.
Found him dead. Yeah, he was just a nice little, you know, kid.
Really?
This is my mom and dad at their wedding, and this was later on when mom and dad had children. They had me, and then there were a number of years. It was actually 12.
Zero.
Yeah, 13, yes, something, yes, 29 or something, Surf Avenue.
Also run by gypsies.
And she wasn't gypsy, she was an Irish blonde. She was all dressed up.
She pretended to be a gypsy, right?
No, she just used to read, she didn't really pretend to be a gypsy, but she used to read tea leaves, and she was very nice, Miss McKay. Very, very nice, she used to come here, and very proper. She had a little aristocratic attitude about her, you know, air about her.
She was also royalty, I guess.
Yeah, then you had Murray Zarek with his animals, and he used to come in and ask me for the... Yeah, save me the drippings from the chicken fat, from the chickens you roast, he says. And I mix it with the dry food, and the animals love it, you know. Oh, God, what a life. It's been some trip.
Today's, you know, the last day?
Yeah, today I think will be the last of it. I don't think there's very much. I want it to be less. I mean, I could drag this out and on, you know, come down, you see everybody, and then you lose time, but I'd like it to be the last. I'd like to get this off my back, because I have, you know, as I said, get this all this responsibility away, and then I want to take care of my financial problems, and then I have a nice clear head to work with. I can work, I can be myself, and that's the one thing I want to be.
This all paper.
Oh,
I got to give that to the garbage man, you know. So that other box you took, there was two boxes,
yeah,
and then
one had all papers in it, garbage. You know what I mean?
All right,
not food. It was all papers.
Yeah, throw it out.
No problem. Let's see. Is there anything else now? Well, the appointment, and we'll get it done. And they give you another, I think, 50 years. Wait a minute. Let me move this over.
Go to the van, right?
Yeah, just bring it outside for now.
Uh-huh.
He's not here yet. When he comes back,
Karate chop? We'll see. All right, Jimmy.
Okay, then. And then we'll... I gave everything away. I gave my shovels everything yesterday, and I have a shovel to pick it up with now. But I, you know what I do have? After the 60 years of working here and making sales, I have to show you what I have left now. Now go get all the money that I made. What happened? It's gone. Maybe I got it in here. No. No. I must have misplaced it. Either that or I spent it. You can't put that in your pocket and take it out. It's sad. I feel like you could come back, open up again, and start all over. And look forward to another 60 years. I always wanted to, in front of the store, to wave like this and say, thanks for the memories.